Hello students, today we begin with a new textbook of geography for class 9th. This year you will be learning some detailed concepts of geography like natural events that occur on the earth, human geography, economy and development in a comprehensive manner. So let's begin with our first chapter, distributional maps. Introduction. You must have studied district, state, and country maps in previous classes in geography subject. The main aim of maps is to show location of a place and distribution of variables. Some maps are prepared with special themes. Such maps are called thematic maps. Through such maps, distribution of variables is shown. Distribution of temperature, rainfall, population, etc. is shown on the map according to the data of variables. These maps are useful to explain the distribution of the variables in the region. Such maps easily brings out the patterns of distribution. To draw distributional maps, we need statistical data of the variables. Distribution can be shown in the three following ways on a map by the dot method, choropleth method and isopleth method. So let us understand what is dot method. A dot map is prepared using statistical data. While preparing dot map, only data gathered by counting is used. This way, a variable is distributed throughout the region. The dots are used to show its distribution on the map. So for example, population map or a cattle population. To show distribution through dot method, the value of the dot has to be determined. To do that, the lowest and the highest value of a variable in a region are taken into consideration. Accordingly, the number of dots are determined. Also, we need to consider the size of the dot, the density of the variable and the scale of the map. The number of dots to be given for the value of variable in each sub-administrative unit needs to be decided first. For example, you can see the map of Kolhapur district on the screen. If you see in the index, a red color dot shows us 5000 population. Each dot is 5000 population. Then if you come down in the index, you'll see the pink color dots. The pink color dots which are changing in size. The smallest one, the value is 50,000 and the largest one, the value is 20 lakhs. This means that the number of dots are determined, the value of the dots are fixed, and as well as that, the size of the dot is also decided. Next, there are some precautions which should be taken while using the dot method for a map. The first one is the size of a dot should be uniform. The size should be decided depending upon the value of the population, the number of population. Second, the distribution of physiography, water resources, transportation system, etc. of a region should be considered while placing a dot on the map. While showing population distribution, rural population is shown by dots and urban population is shown by circle. Fourth, the dot method is more suitable for that variable which is easily scattered across a region. So the next method is choropleth method. In these maps, the data regarding various geographical variables is shown by shades or tints of various colors. While making such maps, the data used for different variables is obtained through various processes such as measurements, surveying, etc. In this method, the value is given to one sub-administrative unit in a region. The smallest and the largest value of the given data of the variable are taken into consideration. After that, 5 to 7 classes are made. Each class is assigned a tint of the same color or black and white patterns. The shades or patterns become darker with the increasing value of the given variable and are drawn accordingly on the map in the given classification. So you can see in this map, Amravati, the lines are more closer to each other, wherein if you see Chikhaldhara, the lines are far away from each other. That means lines which are closer have more population and lines which are far away from each other have less population. Same thing you can notice in this map, that in Amravati the pink shade is darker and in Chikhaldara it is lighter. So in both the ways we can prepare the choropleth map. Now we come to our last method, that is isopleth method. You have seen contour maps and isobar maps in earlier classes. In these maps, the distribution was shown with the help of line joining equal values. When the distribution of a variable is continuous, the isopleth method is then used to show its distribution. For example, altitude, temperature, rainfall, etc. For these maps, we need the accurate data regarding the rainfall, temperature, altitude, etc. of some places in a region. It is assumed that the difference between the altitude and rainfall of two places changes at a minimum rate. The sub-administrative units are not taken into consideration here. Statistical data belongs to the respective places. Such data is called as point-related data, which means the values of variable are written on the map at their respective location. If the data for more places is available, mapping of distribution can be done more accurately. On the basis of this information, isopleth maps are prepared using the steps below. First, by considering the highest and the lowest value of the variables. Second, the class interval is decided to draw the isopleth maps, which in turn decides the difference between the lines. Third, lines are drawn for the decided intervals. Location with the same value are joined by the lines. The following conclusions are drawn on the basis of the maps prepared in such a way. First, if the lines are closer to each other, then the change in the variable is steep, and if the lines are far away from each other, then it is gentle. Second, we get an idea of the natural trend of the distribution of the variable with the help of this map. So through this part of the lesson, we have covered up about distributional maps and the methods used to draw distributional maps, like dot method, choropleth method and isopleth method. The next topic which we'll cover up in part 2 is about geographical field visit, which will continue in the next video. I hope you understood this part of the lesson. Thank you very much.